It's me, your guy, here to tell you about a piece of oil in a disc shape with grooves in it, and contained within the grooves are musical notes, the musical performance of a musical quartet made up of four blokes who call themselves the Beatles. Not as in each one calls themselves the Beatles, as in the band is made up of the Beatles, the Beatles, the Beatles, and the Beatles, as in the name of the group as a whole is the Beatles. That's enough of that then, let's get on with the review! So the first track on Rubber Soul, and I've got my own Rubber Souls here to show you. How do you like that, Rubber Soul? Is Drive My Car. I would not recommend you steer like that, or you'll be arrested or die. Anyway, the song Drive My Car is by Paul McCartney and Jonathan Lennon. And the story of this little ditty is that there's a man and he wants this woman, and this woman has these crazy delusions of being famous, and she's like to this guy, yeah, you can drive my car, I'm gonna be a star. Then she isn't, but because of that's not a normal heart. It is Valentine's Day when I'm recording this, by the way. That tells you how on schedule I am, if you do a bit of maths and figure out when that is. Because of love, they get together anyway. I'm putting this in at number 23, because it's not excellent, but it's not bad. I'd call it quite good. Yes.
Never let another girl like you whip me over. Never let another girl like you drag me under. If I need another girl like you, I will tell her. Never want another girl like you.
Next up at number 8, it's Norwegian Wood, brackets, This Bird Has Flown, brackets. If you didn't know, bird is an informal British word for woman. And so you might say, hey, that bird over there is well fit. And then to which she'd say, age like this cake. And you'd say, mate, did you make that cake yourself? And then she'd say, no, mate, it's a fake bake. As in a fake bake, she didn't, you know, what, fuck it. Anyway, the actual song, I think, is a feminist anthem. Because if you really think about it, you know, the first line, I once had a girl, or should I say, she had me, which is really implying that the woman here is the one wearing the theoretical golf trousers within the relationship, and the man is just some other guy. And the woman is the one controlling the conversation, controlling the evening. He's going to her house and crawling up into her bath to sleep.
Probably not unlike this.
Yeah, and she's got a job, which at the time might have been a bit strange. Anyway, that's all I have to say on it. I think the anthology version is slightly better, however, as it has more of that groovy sitar action, which is what we really like here at my dad's bedroom, which is where I'm filming this, if you didn't know, because it's bigger than mine. And also less grey. I find it makes for a nicer background. Only thing is it's covered in photos of baby me, which I'm not the biggest fan of. Anyway, that's going in at number 8. That's all I have to say on it. And I'll see you in about 12 seconds for the next song. Filming the bit in the bath anyway, I thought I'd give you some new scenery. This is my nan's bathroom, because we all know all my videos are filmed in other people's bedrooms and very often bathrooms.
Anyway, the next song on the album, Rubber Soul by the Beatles, is You Won't See Me, which is going in at number 12, I hope. Anyway, I like it. I like it because I like the story, and I'd always look for a story in a song, which is why I invented the genre scum. You know, story composing underlying music, or something like that. I think this is a scum song. Not a disco record, you know, because disco hasn't been invented yet. Did you see that? Tongue of concentration there, that's how you know you're really getting into the dance. Anyway, I rattled on for 1 minute and 9 seconds now without even talking about the song. I like the ooh ba 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 bit to it, which is lovely. I like Paul's vocals, which are undoubtedly very much better than what I just did there. That's all I can really say on the music right now, because it's not very musically unique. Nothing I can really say about it musically. I think I noticed the story and the vocals more. And background music, although the background music is very nice and adds to the song very well. That's what I've got to say. This has been Ed Miliband's speech for in on the front of their Labour Party, 26th of August, 2010. Good night to you all. Have a good rest and cuddle your teddy bear and buckle your seatbelt.
With the magic of video editing, I have come here to tell you it is not in 12th, but in fact in 10th place.
Nowhere Man, the fourth song on Rubber Soul, yeah? It always reminds me of this one study I read where they found out 5% of humanity has absolutely no thoughts and goes through life, you know, just going through the motions, like little robot men. Which is what we were all trained to be when we did our fascist GCSEs. Anyway, let's not get political today. Nowhere Man is very obviously a John song. That rhymes. Unlike a strange bit in the song, which you would imagine would rhyme, doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to, isn't he a bit like me and you? All rhymes. Point you to. But no, it's you and me, and it doesn't rhyme. How weird is that? Why would they completely intentionally not rhyme it when there's a very obvious rhyme? But anyway, it's a song about thinking for yourself. Speaking of thinking for yourself. It's Think For Yourself at 35. This is a song I used to listen to when I felt really angsty and just hated all authority. It's about George scolding someone of ambiguous age, sexuality, hair colour, gender, breakfast choice and teeth colour, and tell them you're living wrong, you're doing wrong things for the wrong reasons, fix your life. I'd love to say that to many, many people, but that would just be incredibly awkward because most of those people I see on a weekly basis. I do like attacking strangers, however. Anyway, this is all getting sound extremely annoying. Which isn't really irregular, but on this occasion, I sound extremely, extremely annoying. But anyway, the actual song itself, yeah? I like that. Bum, 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 bum. And if you are over time. Like that instrument, whatever it may be, I think you might call it a guitar. I like that. I like the chorus. That one. I could honestly release an album completely made of me making mouth noises. 35 is going in number 35. Goodbye, get out of here. I'll see you in 12 seconds for the next song. Well, hey, new room. Anyway, at number 52, it is The Word, which is a bit of a meta song, because the main word in The Word is word. I think it's sort of precursored, like all those peace and love songs that came later. And it's sort of meta, because it's like a parody of them before they even existed, which is... absolutely crazy. But anyway, it's all right. It's not too bad. It's not too great either. So it's going in at number 52. You know what? When I was 3 years old, I physically could not reach across this sideboard, and now, like, easy, can't even see my hand. But anyway, next song on Rubber Soul, and I'm glowing, and that's better, is Michelle, which I think is a very nice song. It's on record as being a comedy song, which I find a bit strange. I think it's a bit more romantic than that. I think it's a Dublin. I think it's from Dublin in Ireland. No, I don't. That's a load of bullshit. I think it's a deeply romantic experience. Paul's voice, the guitar, it's chill, you know? I'm looking at this reflecting onto here, which is crazy. Like, there's me here, and then there's also me reflecting on this cyborg, which isn't showing up on camera. There's also me on the camera. That was a load of pointless natter. But anyway, yeah, it's going in at number 19, because I think it's very good. It's a unique Beatles experience, because it's so lovely and romantic, as opposed to Everybody Got Something to Hide, except for me and my monkey, and, you know, Revolution, which is a bit more angry. Yeah, I enjoy it. And now, it's time to go on to side two. I'm in Amsterdam on holiday. I've just been to the bloody red light district and seen all that sexy women. Anyway, my dad's gonna get me some Sambuca from the bar, so I guess this would be an appropriate time to do a bit of filming for the video, which was supposed to come out yesterday, but who cares? By the way, it's Wednesday. What Wednesday? We don't know. Anyway, next track on the album, first on side two, is What Goes On by Ringo Starr. Associates. It's good. I like it. I like that line, you didn't even think of me as someone with a name. That's a very good line. Did you mean to break my heart and watch me die? It really raises the stakes in the middle of the song. Like, Jesus Christ, you went from, aw, a bit sad, oh, my girlfriend doesn't like me, to, you've ended my life. You've actually ended my life. So a bit of a raising stakes there. But not enough to ruin the song. I think it's a solid 37th placer. You know what I mean? Yeah, I know what I mean, because I'm saying it. Oh dear! After What Goes On, it's Girl, which used to be my favourite Beatles song, but has now fallen so far to 8th. Anyway, I like this one. I particularly like the last verse about breaking your back to earn your day of leisure. Now, that's quite meaningful, isn't it? That's like, you got to work, you can't just expect. I think it's more relevant now than it's ever been, you know, with millennials and that, and what the news is saying about us. How dare they? How very dare you, good sir? Anyway, I think that it's an excellent song, good tune. I love the bit in the middle where they say tit, 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 tit. Because the Beatles love tits, fun fact.
Funny! Very funny! Anyway, yeah. I like the in the middle of the chorus. And I like the chorus itself. Perhaps just the word girl twice or three times. A lady. Anyway, if you want to know how I'm filming this, I've got my legs between two beds. And I've got it camera set up on top of that light. Anyway, that TV in the background isn't tiny. It's actually this big. Optical illusions. Here I go. Hiding in the cupboard. Little tune in I'm Looking Through You with an amazing vocal performance by Sir Paul McCharmley and some lovely da-da-da-da's on the guitar by some other bloke, I guess. Anyway, did you know this is in fact the messiest Beatles song ever written or recorded, I suppose. You can hear the microphone squeaking, one of the chords goes dead. Goes all quiet, yeah. And also, yeah, you can hear stray guitar notes just throughout the song, but you got to listen really carefully. There is a very useful video that points all of this out, and I'm sure you can find that somewhere on YouTube. In fact, I'll link it in the description so you don't have to go and find it.
Possibly one of the most overrated Beatles songs of all time. I'm not saying it is bad, but it is not as good as people say it is. I think it is slightly overzealous. No, I don't even know what that means, actually. Overconfident? That is what overzealous means, but that's not what I'm trying to say. It's less deep to me than a lot of people make it to them. I don't really find it to be a very emotional song. I think it's a bit of a dud in that front. I think I've cried once to it, but that was set to a in memory of Brian Epstein video, but it was before he died, so it's not really in memory of Brian Epstein at all, and that's a farce. But I'm putting it in number 42. It's a mid-league song. It's not as good as What You're Doing or like I'm Looking Through You. Or Twist and Shout, which is still at number one somehow, but that'll change maybe in the next five albums more. I'm insane. Good advice to friends unheeded. The best of plans mislaid. Just looking for a new direction. Weight is that bad. The issue with it is that it's in the middle of a really good album. And it's not actually that good, and that's why it's at number 75, which sounds like a really, really incredibly low number, you know. But it's like lower mid at this point, because there's like 86 Beatles songs, I think, I don't know. 83. Not yet, but by the end of this album there will be. I know, because I had to do all the lists, which takes forever, may I have you know. But anyway, wait. The only bit I like is the bit where it says, I've been good, as good as I can be. I like that line. Just because it's interesting. But the actual verses I don't like. I like the chorus. I don't love it, but I do quite like it. So that's alright, I guess. But the verses are a bit rubbish! And that's why it's only at number 75. But that's what I've got to say, really. So on to the next song. Here I go, moving physically to the next song.
Forming of a new connection. To study or to play.
And so the conversation turned until the sun went down.
If I needed someone, it's probably one of George's worst numbers, only coming in at 58, even though I would totally wank him off. Anyway, you know what? The second time on this album, yeah? That's something as for no reason not rhymed. Blah, 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 other day, it might not have been like this. As opposed to, had you come some other day, it might not have been this way. What have they thought? Right, we're going to get really high. And then we're going to do some rubbish songs. Then we're going to not be high. Then we're going to do some good songs. But because we were high and now we're cool cats, we're not going to make them rhyme. Because we're hard. We're Burnley. I mean, we're the Beatles. We can do what we like. And then they stop rhyming, but only on like two lines in the whole album. But anyway, that just bugs me. Really gets me down. Really tickles my pickle. No, that's good. That's not what people say. Really gets my goat. Yeah, that's it. Really gets my gorgonzola. It does. Really gets my Gareth Southgate. Really gets my Gary Barlow, you know? Really gets my Gareth Bale. Really gets it. Ah, it hurt my teeth. Hang on. That's blood. Anyway, yeah. So that's all I've got to say about if I needed someone. Which is a bit forgettable, really. On to the final track. I'm going to physically move downwards into my basement.
And many fantasies were learned on that day.
Keep feeling fascination, passion burning, love so strong. Keep feeling fascination.
And the final song on the album, Rubber Soul, is Run For Your Life, which is a bit violent, actually. Sounds a bit abusive to me. But we're not going to judge John. We know he beats women. That's just how it was. And it's sad. As a cup. But anyway, let's talk about the song. He's very shouty in it. He's got a very aggressive tone in his voice. I like the lyrics. They're a bit intellectual. Like, toe the line. Who says toe the line apart from intellectuals? I like that phrase. Very good phrase. Very nice phrase. Probably the best part of the part about the song. He also said, "Let this be a sermon." But at the same time, he's saying he wants his girlfriend to be dead if she ever has another boyfriend, which is a bit crazy, a bit mad. Not like me. I'm like just a bit kooky. I'm perfectly innocent. Like I don't wish death upon people. Apart from Tories. No, I bet we've got like a 25% Tory audience. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, the song, it's got guitars in it, hasn't it? Yeah. It's also got people's voices, people's vocal cords. Vocal cords are an instrument. Do you know that? Yeah. Yeah. And it's also got some drums in it. And the drums are quite good. They're not anything like that. That's just me tapping on my legs.
Wow, it's another 3 days later, and I'm back in England. How lovely. Really looking forward to the Crystal Palace versus Leicester City match tonight. But anyway, Run For Your Life is going in at number 40. Thank you, and good night.